Important solid fossil fuel in the Earth's crust and can be defined as a combustible sedimentary rock occurring in mineable quantities in distinct layers, beds or seams. It is formed from the accumulations of plant remains which get modified by chemical, biological and physical processes during and after the burial of vegetable debris. Workable coal resources in India are mainly confined to the lower Gondwana sequence, formed about 270 million years ago. The Gondwana supergroup occurs mostly in three principal belts, the Koel Damodar Valley, the Sone Mahanadi Valley, and the Pranahita Godavari Valley. The Pranahita Godavari Valley extends from the north of Boregaon of Maharashtra state up to Eluru on the east coast of Andhra Pradesh, broadly following the course of the Godavari and Pranahita rivers. It has a length of about 470 kilometers and an aerial extent of 17,000 square kilometers. The adjacent part in the state of Maharashtra is designated as the Vardha Valley Coalfield. The state of Andhra Pradesh ranks fifth in the list of states endowed with coal resources, with its 10,856 million tons constituting around 5.5% of the country's resources of 1,96,911 million tons. The proved coal reserves of Andhra Pradesh is 6,201 million tons. The Singareni Collieries Company Limited, a government concern, is the sole authority for coal mining in Andhra Pradesh. It caters to the needs of all the powerhouses and dependent industries in South India. Coal production-wise, it contributes 10.2% out of the national production figure of 246.4 million tons for 1993-94. The first coal was discovered in the Godavari Valley coalfield in 1870 by Dr. William King. Geologists conduct mapping of the area and they find out the possibility of the existence of coal. The exposure of the coal seams to the surface of the earth is called an outcrop. It indicates the existence of coal in that area. The geological mapping is followed by coal exploration. Coal exploration involves a multidisciplinary approach where geology and drilling are the main disciplines. Geophysics, hydrogeology, and geoengineering are some of the disciplines that play a vital supporting role. In coal exploration, the steps involved are detailed mapping, detailed drilling, confirmation of structure of block, reserves estimation, and geological documentation. The coal seams are available in the Barakar formation. Since its inception, 13,61,989 meters of drilling has been carried out for coal exploration in the Singareni collieries in 8,112 boreholes. As of date, the deepest borehole drilled is 800 meters deep. Coal is mainly used as a source of thermal energy. Coal is mostly used in the generation of electricity in powerhouses, cement factories, running locomotives and steamers, manufacture of fertilizers, and so on. Coal is used to produce coal gas, coal tar, producer gas for the manufacture of activated carbons to use in the sugar industry, to make oil, that's petrol and diesel, artificially from coal, and so on. The main consumers of the Singareni coal are powerhouses, cements, railways, fertilizers, heavy water plants and others. Coal is supplied by rail, road and conveyor belt to the consumers. Coal is not homogeneous. It consists of three or four bands. The bands found in coal are the bright band known as vitrain, the durain band which looks dull, the thin, alternately thin, dull and bright bands called clarain, and the fusain band which, unlike the above three bands, soils the fingers. The quality of the coal depends on the presence of these bands. Based on the useful heat value of coal, it is divided from A grade to G grade, where A grade is considered as prime grade quality, having about 6200 UHV, and G grade as having 1300 UHV. Coal is extracted using mainly three methods. This depends upon the depth of occurrence of the coal seams. The mode of approach to the coal seam by making tunnels is known as the incline mine or underground mining. Usually, the underground mines are confined to a depth of 300 meters. So far, about 100 mines have been started in the Singareni collieries, while around 33 have been closed in phases. As of today, 56 inclined mines and 3 shaft mines are in operation in the collieries. In open cast mining, the coal seams available at the surface or near the surface of the earth are mined. The maximum depth permissible for mining in open cast mining is 150 meters, depending upon the ratio of removal of overburden and the thickness of the coal seam. In the Singareni collieries, the first open cast mine was introduced in 1975. As of today, 9 open cast mines are in operation. The walking drag line was introduced in the Ramagundam open cast for the removal of overburden during 1986. When the workings in the underground mine reaches beyond 300 meters depth in incline mining, vertical shafts are sunk from the surface, known as shaft mining. This method of mining facilitates the workmen to reach the work spot at the earliest. In incline and shaft mining, two types of extraction of coal are in practice, known as the bord and pillar method and long wall mining. In the bord and pillar method of mining, the coal seam is divided into several blocks known as pillars by driving tunnels or galleries cut in four directions through the coal seam. These pillars provide natural support to the overlying rock. In the second stage of working, coal is extracted from these pillars known as depillaring, and this method of mining is done manually. Long wall mining is machine mining, where the preparation of galleries and panels and the extraction of coal is done by machines. The first long wall mining was introduced in the Singareni collieries during 1983. Underground mining in general, and more so coal mining, is a hazardous venture, as it is a continuous struggle against nature and natural forces. The baffling problems are weak roofs, fall of roof and sides, difficult geomining conditions, the presence of water, gas, high temperature due to geothermal gradients, surface subsidence, and various other such factors. More than 50% of the accidents are due to roof falls in coal mines. The reasons for the unstable roof conditions in general, and particularly the geological factors contributing to it, constitutes a major area of scientific study known as geoengineering. The introduction of longwall technology demands the application of principles and methods of geology to the problems of engineering. Geomining studies play a vital role in the coal mining industry. They operate at several stages of mining, like tunneling, sinking of vertical shafts, determination of caving index, capacity of power supports in longwall mining, and so on. Geoengineering studies are undertaken to address the geoengineering problems of coal mines. These studies in the coal mining industry are categorized as pre-mine development, where geoengineering studies are made before opening the mine, and in-mine development, where a detailed underground scan line mapping is carried out to generate the structural data and geomechanical classification of roof rocks. Pre-mine development. Before opening a mine, with the available surface data, mining conditions can be forecast. Further, this data and studies are confirmed after opening a mine. Geotechnical log. Geotechnical log provides detailed information about rock quality designation, spacing of fractures, nature of bedding, groundwater level, extent of weathering, structural features like slicken sides, joints, and core dip and lamination in the strata. While logging the borehole core samples, geologists observe the above factors to assess the quality of rock mass. Laboratory tests. In coal mining, the data on strength parameters is an important aid in planning the layout of underground excavation and the evaluation of support requirements. Exploratory boreholes are identified to conduct physico-mechanical properties in the laboratory to assess the roof rock stability of coal seams. The borehole core samples are first prepared to the specified size to conduct the tests with the help of a cutting machine. The cylindrical sample is then cut to the specified size based on the diameter of the cylindrical sample. After cutting the sample on either sides, the planes are polished smoothly on a polishing machine. These samples are then baked in an oven. On these core samples, the following tests are then conducted. Uniaxial compressive strength. The cylindrical sample is axially kept in the universal testing machine and the load is axially applied to failure. The compressive strength of rock is expressed in kgs and centimeters by using the following equation. SC is equal to F by A, where SC is equal to compressive strength, F is equal to applied load, and A is the area of cross-section. Tensile strength. The Brazilian test is the most commonly used indirect method for determining the tensile strength of rock. In this method, the cylindrical rock core is compressed diametrically between the semicircular jaws under UTM. The tensile strength is expressed by using the following equation. ST is equal to 2F by pi DL, where ST is equal to tensile strength, F is applied load, D the diameter of the sample, and L is the length of the sample. Young's modulus. The original shape and size to which the material returns when the external load removes all the stresses, strains and displacements is measured from this natural state. The property of recovering from strain of a material is called elasticity. The modulus of elasticity for a rock is obtained from the stress-strain graph. Point load strength index. This is a field test usually carried out by geologists in the mapping directly using the sample without any sample preparation. This is a portable piece of equipment which can be carried out into the field. Any irregular sample from the rock exposures or cylindrical samples can be used to conduct this test. The sample is kept between two points and load is applied till failure. Considering the volume of the sample, the point load strength index is determined from the following equation. F is equal to P by V to the power of 2 by 3. P is the failure load, V is the volume of the sample. Proto-diacono strength index. This test consists of mainly two units. In order to carry out the test, coal samples are poured into the cylinder and crushed with the drop weight. Samples of crushed coal are placed on a wide screen and screened. The strength coefficient F is determined from the equation F is equal to 103 by I, where F is the proto-diacono strength index and I is the number of impacts. Weathering test. If a rock is subjected to weathering, its strength properties will change when compared to a fresh rock. To determine the effect of weathering on roof rocks of coal seams, two tests are conducted. Swelling index. The clay minerals in the exposed root strata absorb water molecules and subsequently swell, leading to bed separation. This test is conducted on samples by keeping it in a water beaker, and the swelling strain is then recorded at regular intervals from the strain gauge. Slake durability test. To find out the changes in seasonal wetting and drying of the exposed roof rock, the slake durability test is conducted. For this test, 500 grams of sample is broken into more or less 10 equal pieces and kept in the test drum, which is then partially immersed in the water. The drum is rotated at a speed of 20 rpm for 10 minutes. The weight percentage of the sample remained in the drum gives the slake durability index of the sample. Hard draw grindability index. In order to know the relative case of grinding or power required for grinding coals, a standard test known as hard draw grindability test is carried out. This test is useful where coal is to be pulverized. In this test, a definite pressure of 64.5 pounds on the balls is maintained. And after 60 revolutions of the vertical shaft, the machine is stopped and the ground material is sieved. Geoengineering characteristics and caving parameters. The data generated from the laboratory tests are graphically presented to assess the stability of roof rocks. These are known as geoengineering characteristics. The caving index number is derived for all projects to assess the caving characteristics of overlying rocks. Accordingly, it will be useful to estimate the capacity of hydraulic supports. Lithological characters of roof strata. The lithology of the roof and their structure play an important role in unstable roof conditions. The preparation of different types of maps will help to find the roof lithological behavior and identify the areas prone to roof instability. For the purpose of finding out the lithological behavior in the roof of coal mines, preparation of different types of maps will help in locating potential hazardous zones. Relative distribution of sandstone and shale percentage maps. By considering the distribution of sandstone and shale in the roof, percentage maps are prepared. By superimposing on each other, these maps outline a channel. The differential compaction along the channel bodies weakens the roof. Lithologic frequency map. This map is prepared by considering a number of rock beds constituting 30 meters of mine roof. Where the number of litho units are less, that area is relatively stable. High and very high frequency area is regarded as potentially unstable roof area. Fence diagram. In the fence diagram, the aerial relationship of the several stratigraphic cross sections can be represented in a three-dimensional view. Average extraction ratio map. Average extractions are calculated by considering the original height of the gallery and the height of roof falls. It gives the distribution of roof falls in a given block. In mine development. After making an opening in the mine, a detailed scan line mapping is conducted to plot the different geological features that affect the mining conditions. The roof instability in the coal mines is influenced by certain geological features such as clay dikes, cut and fill structures, falls, slicken size, and so on. Underground mapping. Faults and slips. These are major factors in the roof conditions as they constitute structural weaknesses. Near the fault slip plane, the roof rock breaks into pieces, resulting in roof faults. Coffin cover is one type of configuration in which two slips intersect in the roof and promote roof faults. Because of faults, variation in gradient can also be observed. Slicken sides. Slicken sides are smooth, polished and striated. The slicken sides constitutes a discontinuity in the roof and therefore weakens the roof. Joints. Roof stability is mainly dependent on the nature, orientation, spacking and number of joint sets which play a significant role in the roof faults. Fractures. Fracture planes in the sides or roof cause potential hazards and are sometimes filled with secondary minerals like calcite. Cut and fill structure. Near the roof of the gallery, sandstone bodies are sometimes found. That part of the coal which is cut and filled with sandstone is known as cut and fill structure. Along the contact of sandstone and coal, compactional slicken sides can be observed which cause roof faults. Different forms of sandstone bodies can be noticed in the coal. Pillow structure in sandstones. When sandstone forms the roof of the seam, sometimes a pillow structure can be observed which contributes to roof faults. Flazer bedding. Thinly and closely laminated sandstone in the roof causes roof faults. These planes are weak with the alignment of flaky minerals like mica and is called as flazer bedding. Leaf impressions. Sometimes leaf impressions can be observed in the roof. The poor cohesiveness along the planes of the leaf impressions causes separation and leads to roof fall. Strata control. With the mining advancement, the behavior of overlying strata is essential to study as the beds above the excavation tend to separate themselves from the subsequent beds. Convergence studies. Convergence studies are conducted in long wall mining to measure the sagging of overlying strata. Caving index. An advanced knowledge of caving of overlying strata is essential to estimate the capacity of hydraulic supports and to find out whether overlying strata is easily caveable. It is estimated with an equation of I is equal to SC L to the power of N T to the power of 0.5 by 5. Geomechanical classification. The classification of roof rocks for mining excavation is useful for predicting the behavior of overlying strata to prepare the roof support plan. Finite element method. The relation between the alignment of galleries or tunnels in respect of principal stores direction indicates the strata control problems and will be useful in choosing the preferred tunnel alignment.
Records show that 50% of accidents in underground coal mines are due to roof faults alone. A documentation of the geological causes of roof faults in underground coal mines are required. The strength of the rock is usually considered in mine planning to prepare a support plan. Still, we are finding unstable roof conditions in coal mines and is a clear evidence that the other geoengineering factors are contributing for this factor. Traditionally, the board and pillar method of mining is followed in Indian coal mining, and in the recent past, a long wall, open cast and machine mining are introduced to meet the high production of coal. Before taking up these high investive projects, it is definitely required to generate a data bank on geoengineering properties.